She's in love with who I am. Back in high school, I used to bust it to the dance. Yeah. Now I hit the FBO with duffels in my hands. I did half a Xan, 13 hours till I land. Had me out like a light, ayy, like a light, ayy, like a light, ayy. Slept through the flight, ayy, not for the night.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Adrian the Barber. Back at you guys with another video. I know it's been a while since I posted. I've been really busy cutting hair with the holidays and everything. But I'm ready to get back into this, so it's going to be my first tutorial I'm doing on the channel, first of many. Let's just get this tutorial started and get back into it. As you can see, we've been putting in the first guideline with my wall detailer wireless. This step, pretty simple. Make it right under the earlobe around there. Nice and clean guidelines, clean everything up under, and then get ready to hit it with your shavers after. All I'm gonna be doing here is grabbing my Slimline Pros, clean that guideline up a little bit more, getting that hair nice and bald before I hit it with the balder, just to make it a smoother transition, doesn't pull hair or anything. And yeah, that's about it. After we hit it with the ballers, I'm gonna grab my 1.5 guard open and just get rid of all that bulk that's down there. Make it a more clean space so you can go under with your half guard and be able to get that first 2-3 guidelines in without having all that bulk there. Here I'm gonna be grabbing my wall wireless magic clips. Gonna be opening that lever all the way up, going up about an inch around, and getting that second guideline in to start this fade out. Now I'm gonna be going open and closing that lever, trying to get that first guideline out. When you're working with a very bold line into that, like the half transition, it's always gonna be the hardest guideline to get out, in my opinion. So make sure you take it easy, go slow with it. Start with the lever closed, make your way up, or go the opposite, start with your lever open, make your way down. Just make sure you make your way all the way closed on that first guideline. Now I'm gonna be grabbing my one guard, opening that all the way up. This is how I do every single fade, every single taper, no matter what I'm doing. Every time I'm doing any kind of fading, I always go from zero, bald, then I go half, then I grab my one guard and open that up. I do this one and open first to clear it once again, more bulk, and then it makes it easier to grab that half guard and open that up, and that guideline will disappear with those two guards. Grab that half guard, open it all the way up. When you have a half guard on, you open it all the way, it's like having a one guard basically. So I grab that one open, which is technically 1.5. Now I have that half guard open, which is basically a one. And I'm cleaning up all that hair under, getting that guideline out. And this is where you start seeing the fade come together. Grab my 1.5 guard once again, open again, and make a new guideline with that. After I cleared all the bulk with it, I'm gonna make a new guideline. Open that up all the way, and then I'm gonna be following that with that 1.5 guard closed. So basically what I do every time when I fade is I grab that guard and I go open first. Make my guideline up, then I close it and go down and clean that hair up under. We'll be right back. here. I'm gonna be grabbing my half guard right now. Excuse me, my one guard, and cleaning up under all that hair again. Make sure everything's clean, all my guard lines are in place, everything's equal from one side to another. Now I'm gonna be grabbing my two guard, open, getting rid of all that bulk on top, making this fade really come together. As you see, it has all that hair on top. I'm actually gonna go over all the bottom part with the three to clean all that hair all the way up to the, you see that part right at the top of his hair? Right here, this is where I got the three, closed, all the way up to that part line. That's where we're gonna separate his hair. And we're gonna go over it all the way around with the three. Some more detail work, grabbing my half guard open, just trigger playing with it, make sure that fade's coming out nice and clean. Here I'm going to be lining up the sides. You don't want to push this part back too much, keep it natural, just get rid of all those long hairs laying over. Just make sure you do it natural, just like you would do to a hairline. You should do it right here around the ear. Everything should be nice and clean, nice and natural. Detailing clippers, the Andis Masters, getting rid of all those little guidelines, making sure everything comes out clean. I generally don't use a guard on these, I just like to do detail work with them. As you can see, we parted his hair off, getting ready to start the side taper. I grab my three guard because that's what we finish with at the end, and I'm going all the way up with that. This is what honestly makes this taper stand out the most, is when you have that guideline nice and bald at the bottom, makes the taper pop. So here we go almost all the way up to that guideline, but leave enough room to be able to go with your most zero gap clippers and get that little line out. That way it's easier when you're fading.
Following that one and a half,
zero and a half guard, open again, getting rid of that second guideline. You'll see me putting it on right here. Always open, remember, start with open. Make your way down to close. Once I see that fade's clean and everything looks nice, I'm gonna grab my magic clips, open, no guard, clean up those little hairs that I see. Anything that bothers me, takes 2 seconds to make your fade look a lot nicer. I'm gonna reclip his hair because it's coming out of place. Make sure everything stays smooth. You never want to take off hair from the top. All the straining hairs, it's part of the top hair keeper sections. There, this is a 1.5 guard, open. Going up another inch, keeping everything clean. You're just gonna see me doing detailing work here. One and a half, or one is what I have on right now. I have it open, which is the one and a half. Cleaning the taper up. After this, I'm going to be grabbing the three, going all the way up again. Make sure I got all those hairs. Following that with the two and a half to clean up everything. I hope you guys are understanding. Let me know in the comments if you guys want me to go a little slower next time and explain a little better. It's the first one. I'm just trying to get it down. Taper up once again, grabbing my Andis Masters, doing detailing work again. Detailing work is what makes your tapers come out good. You need to do detail work after you're done. Go over everything, make sure everything looks nice and clean. DA got that dope. I'm gonna start on his hairline soon. This is probably the easiest part to mess up on a haircut. You gotta make sure you keep everything natural. Him, he has a lot of baby hairs in the front, so what I do is I grab my three guard, clean up that side of part of the taper, make sure those hairs aren't too long on his corners, brush everything down, make sure you get all those hairs down. You don't want to take off any hairs from the top when you're doing the lineup. And then I'm gonna be grabbing some holding spray, spraying that on to make it a lot easier to line up so the hairs don't move when I start lining them up. Once I grab my liners, I start right in the middle. Don't want to push them back. You start at the highest point and make your way from there. Once you're starting at the highest point, you shouldn't be raising any side higher than that. You just follow that guideline from the middle and go straight out to the side. Make sure you guys are taking your time on the hairline part, one of the most important parts of a haircut, so everybody sees. This is me grabbing my masters once again, just going over that work. Grabbing my liners once again, just making sure everything's coming out crispy and the way I want it. I always wait till the end to put around the ear line in. Just once that taper's done, it's a lot easier to put that line in so you don't affect your taper. On this other side of the taper, I'm gonna kind of let you guys just follow along, know what we're doing. Right now, you just see me grab that three and go all the way up as we did up to the other side. Then we're gonna be grabbing that zero, putting our first guideline in. Same steps as the other side, kind of follow along. I'll be putting on the screen what I'm doing at certain points, but I kind of want you guys just to know what's going on in this taper and get an idea. DA got that dope. Thank you. With the straight razoring, it's pretty straightforward. Stretch the skin with one finger. I usually do it with my thumb like that. Stretch the skin out. You make sure you don't cut nobody. And this is what makes the hairline come out crispy and puts the finishing touches on your haircut. And that should basically do it for this video. So sorry for taking so long to upload it, but came out with the banger on this one. Got a next one coming out next week or before. So get ready for the next video. Appreciate all you guys. Make sure you hit that like and subscribe button. I know it's a long video, and thank you for still being here.